Good Morning Bay Street is a production of theuptrend.com and is for information and educational purposes only. The views and opinions expressed in this presentation are those of Stephen Whiteside and should not be considered personal investment advice. Always consult a qualified financial advisor before making any investment decisions. To learn more about the charts featured in this presentation, please visit theuptrend.com. And now, here is Stephen Whiteside with today's newsletter.
Good morning. This is Stephen Whiteside with your daily market outlook for Monday, November 24th, 2008. Let's start off today by looking at the big picture. This is based on the weekly charts. No changes last week. Everything was down across the board. The biggest surprise, of course, is the enormous rise of the U.S. dollar from the summer. Until we see this breakdown on a daily and weekly basis, we will not see money flow back into commodities and the major indexes. For the U.S. dollar, we'd be looking for a weekly close below 84 on the U.S. dollar index to tell us that this current major uptrend in the U.S. dollar is over. Of course, when that happens, we'll see money flow back into commodities. And here's an interesting situation. The natural gas, of course, is hitting new lows at a time when natural gas usage is spiking. And we would need to see a daily close above 740 for natural gas to tell us that this current major downtrend for natural gas is over. Looking at daily trend changes, we saw a big spike in gold on Friday. Gold was up dramatically. We were expecting an up move in gold, early warning signal on Thursday, big spike on Friday, and gold is up again in the pre-market this morning. Looking at the major indexes, we would need to see the TSX close above 9,100 on Monday to give us a new buy signal, 898 on the S&P 500, and 1550 on the NASDAQ. Looking at weekly sector changes for the Canadian market, just saw some money move into gold on Friday. That was enough to give us a weekly buy signal for the gold sector. And there you see it on the right-hand side of the chart there that the Canadian gold sector and the U.S. gold sectors have given weekly buy signals. Looking at daily trend changes, again, we saw money flow into gold. And that also affected some of the material stocks that have a gold component. Looking at moon cycles, next moon cycle is a new moon on November 27th, which is coming up. Market breadth, we saw short-term market breadth move up sharply, up 11% on Friday. This is the percentage of stocks on the TSX trading above their 10-day moving average. It's still down at the bottom of the range in an area where we would expect new uptrends to start. Looking at the long-term market breadth for the TSX, it's still down pretty close to zero. Not a lot of move on Friday. A one-day move will not affect this particular reading, but we are down at the bottom where new major uptrends start. Looking at currencies, again, focused on the U.S. dollar daily chart, 86.50 is where we would have to see us close to give us a new sell signal for the U.S. dollar index. Looking at metals and minerals, again, focused on gold. Big up day on Friday, another up day this morning in the pre-market. And the Is It Safe chart is telling us that it's now safe to get back in the gold market. Looking at energies on crude oil, we're hanging around the $50 area. Hopefully that'll act as support. Looking for a daily close above 58 on Monday to indicate a new buy signal. Looking at exchange-traded funds, last week we talked about gold stocks. Now let's talk about gold. On the TSX, on the Canadian side of the border in Canadian dollars, you can buy the HGU ETF. This is the Horizon Beta Pro Bull ETF, so this is a double long. And you can also buy the DGB in the U.S. in U.S. dollars. It's also a double long ETF for gold itself and not gold stocks. Looking at the most actives, interesting, Bombardier, even though the markets hit new lows last week, Bombardier did not. We need to see a daily close above 450 to give us a new buy signal for this stock. And last but not least, the futures are up this morning based on the fact that the U.S. government is injecting money into Citigroup. Citigroup stock is up anywhere between 30 and 50% this morning in European trading and in the pre-market in North America. I would say that Citigroup stock has probably been wiped out. Investors just don't know it yet or don't want to realize it. But I would imagine that the Citigroup common shares are worthless. But of course, there are enough people in the market to keep it propped up at the moment. Look at our breakpoints for today. We're up in the pre-market in the futures across the board, so we are looking for higher prices at the open on Monday morning. We have seen higher prices in Europe across the board, so we should see a nice spike at the open on Monday. Looking at the hourly charts, I'd be very shocked if we went back down and broke last week's lows. That would tell us that something major, the next leg down is probably going to be sharp and fast and sharp to the downside if we broke last week's lows. Right now, we see the big spike on the right-hand side of the screen going into the last hour of trading. We saw a lot of buying on Friday, certainly not new money. You don't get new money between 3 and 4 o'clock on a Friday. That's just the day traders in there buying, anticipating higher prices this week. That's a bullish sign, certainly not a bullish uptrend yet. So if we break down below
that 60, was Stephen Whiteside with today's Good TSX, Morning Bay Street newsletter. For more information on our charts and services, and please visit theuptrend.com.
All those would tell us that for the NASDAQ, for example, if we break 1295 on the downside, you know, 1250 would be our next logical target. But hey, 1,000 wouldn't be too far away. So you could see a major, major decline of the stock markets if we went down and broke last week's lows. Okay, that's all for Monday morning, folks. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again on Tuesday morning.